I'm Mark Sherry, the Executive Director of the New Music Alliance. The New Music Alliance is a nonprofit organization, and our mission is to help advance the careers of local musicians who write original music from the Western New England area, and to help bring attention to this area as a destination for both music production and performances. And so what is the Essential Western New England Songbook, and why did we create it? Well, the Essential Western New England Songbook is a juried anthology of many of the best songs ever written by Western New England artists. And that includes all of Massachusetts west of Worcester, south in Connecticut, all the way down to the New Haven area, and north up to southern Vermont. It includes all genres of music and was compiled by over 20 music industry professionals from the Western New England area who nominated songs that were then voted on. And so why did we create it? Well, we created the songbook to bring attention to the amazing musical talent that we have here in Western New England. And all of us Western New Englanders, whether we're born here or chose to be here, can take pride in the incredible music that's been produced in this area. Some of the creative musicians producing this music may be now or were your friends or neighbors. There even may be some who are multi-million selling artists that you may not even know are from your home area. And you'll hear some music from some of those people here tonight. And the songbook is also something for posterity. In the future, people will easily be able to look back and listen to many of the best tunes dating back to the 1950s to the present, and all of them recorded here in Western New England. But I think the absolute best thing about the songbook is that it's an incredibly awesome playlist to listen to, either on YouTube or Spotify. And I highly encourage you to check out the full songbook during the coming weeks. But tonight, the focus will be on 10 local musicians whose songs have been inducted into the Essential Western New England Songbook. They'll be appearing here live as part of a panel to talk about their songs as we play a YouTube video of their song. We'll have three groups of panelists tonight, and to introduce the panelists in group one is the emcee of our show, Tracy Walton. And Tracy is the owner and chief engineer at On Deck Recording Studio in Northfield, Connecticut. Tracy's also a super musician who, as a member of the duo Bell of the Fall, has had their song Rise Up inducted into the Essential Western New England Songbook this year. So here he is, Tracy Walton.
Thanks, Mark. Really good to be here. I'm excited to be the emcee for this event, honored to have been asked. It should be a really good show. I'm excited as a member of Bell of the Fall that our song Rise Up has been nominated and accepted into the book. And really excited to get this going and hear the songs and talk with some of the songwriters. So first up, we have Narissa Neild from the group The Neilds from Northampton, Mass. So good to have you with us. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Yeah, we're excited to have you.
Surprise.
Yeah, it was likewise for myself. So it's really nice. I had the pleasure of listening earlier. It's a great song. So I think what we're going to do is right away kind of get into the song, play it, let everyone hear it, and then we can come back and talk about it a little bit. The song is Georgia O from The Neilds.
Taking everything that you deserve.
Oh, it was a little quick clip of it again. That was Georgia O from the Neilds, and we have Narissa Neilds with us here. Really great song. It's hard on these small speakers. I was trying to figure out the production wise what year we were in, and maybe you could tell us a little bit about that. And yeah. I'm assuming you're the primary songwriter.
Yep. Yeah, I wrote the song. I wrote it in 1997. I was going for a run at the Telluride. We were playing the Telluride Bluegrass Festival, and as I was running, I got this phrase in my head: "I want to be a woman like me." And I thought, okay, that's the line I'm going to write towards. That'll be the last line in the song, and it came together pretty quickly. You know, we were traveling all over the country in this 15-passenger van, and spending a lot of time in the Southwest, and we stayed with artists in New Mexico, and you know, sort of learned all about Georgia O'Keeffe. And I was thinking about, you know, how unusual and brave she was at the time, although there's so many women artists who didn't get as much attention as she did. And that's always going to be the case. But anyway, I was basically writing a feminist anthem and a song about self-discovery through art. And so we recorded the song in 1998 for our album Play that came out that same year on Mercury Rounder Records. And it's just been one of our, you know, it's like a song that we play often still to this day.
It's still in the set list.
Oh yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. No, it's a great song. It's always interesting for me to try to think about the writer's record collection and what's in there. It feels like
I'd love to talk about that.
Yeah, I mean, I was a huge fan as a kid, and still like listening once in a while. But it feels like there's some there's a little bit of like Go-Go's vibe in there, in the groove of it, and maybe that's coming from someone in the band or something, but. It has a little hint of that in there.
That's interesting. I wouldn't have put them in our influence list, but
interesting. Okay.
But you know, we were all children of the late 60s. So
sure.
Beatles, Stones, you know, the band, Joni sure. Mitchell was really big for all of us.
Yep.
And then, you know, all of us definitely got a good taste of grunge in the early 90s, and Amy Mann, I would say, is
okay. Yeah, yeah.
Sensibility, and Ani DiFranco, whom I reference in the song.
And I heard that for sure. Yeah.
Yeah.
The what's it? Bachelor. What's that record? Bachelor number or something. The Amy Mann
yeah.
record.
Right.
Is,
yeah.
Which has a little of that vibe as well.
Yeah, I mean the record that we were crazy about was whatever.
Yeah.
I should have known that one.
Sure. Yeah, great stuff. And it's funny, as songwriters, I think all of us kind of, we have those influences, and then we end up as the next kind of generation of writers land in similar spots sometimes.
Absolutely, yeah.
Which is great, you know?
Yeah, I mean, because you can't take away all the years in the 1970s that our ears were filled with pop music that was just everywhere.
Sure, and sure. Was,
you know, there just weren't as many radio stations. Things weren't as segregated. And you know, FM radio was just a big mix of everything.
Yeah, no, for sure.
It was in the stew.
It was a good time, for sure. That's great. Is there anything else you wanted to touch on for that song in general? Or are we maybe we'll bring on the next next contestant on the Essential Songbook.
Right? Yeah. Bring him on.
Yeah. So let's bring Tom Guerra on. Tom, welcome to the show.
Welcome. Thank you very much for having me.
Tom Guerra, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to kind of do this. We're going to be adding songwriters on as we go, and then we'll get the conversation going, and everyone can kind of talk about the different songs. Were you on the stream hearing that last song, Tom?
Yes, I did. It's a great song, Narissa, and I followed you guys over the years. And I was wondering when that came out. I thought late 90s, but real nice production on that, great hook, and just, you know, something I think everybody can relate to, too. You don't have to be a feminist or a female to relate to it. It's just a real solid song, and I love the Georgia O and the Ani reference as well, too.
Well, thank you very much. Well, I guess the one thing I should have said is our bass player, who's now our guitar player, Dave Chalfant, produced this, and he's been our producer for every record since. Like, and we're making our 21st record now. So he's definitely a big part of the sound and creating.
Yeah, the sonics were great, you know.
Thank you. A lot
going on there, but not too much, just enough to keep it interesting, you know.
Good stuff. So what we're going to do is get into the next song, which is Tom Guerra, who's out of Hartford, Connecticut. The song is Sudden Signs of Grace. Great stuff. We're back with Tom Guerra. Really good song. Are you hearing that? You're okay?
I'm hearing that. Thank you.
Yeah, there you go. Yeah, great song. Obviously, probably the first thing you notice is all the cameos. Certainly some familiar faces in there. Tell us a little bit about the song and the production and whatnot.
Yeah, so I was finishing up my fourth solo record. I was with the Mambo Sons for a long time and then started doing solo records in 2014. And I happened to go to church on Christmas Eve, and the reverend there said to me, we're all just looking for, not, didn't said to me, said to the congregation, you know, our goal in life should be to look for those sudden signs of grace. And that phrase stuck with me. And I just, the next day I went for a hike and wrote the whole song in about 20 minutes.
Yeah, it's, I mean, it feels like, you know, so many songs, I think for me, Narissa mentioned it earlier, they start with that phrase. And as songwriters, you know, I feel like I have tons of phrases even right now in my phone where I just jot them down.
Say, oh, right.
Right.
And when you hear a really good one, you're like, oh, yes, I can't wait to write this. Yeah, it was really good. Can we actually, I wanted to bring in so he can get into the discussion as well. Ian Meadows from the Meadows Brothers is going to be popping in. There's Ian. How are
we
doing?
Hey, guys. Great, man. Tom, love the song. Really, really awesome. And definitely resonates with me that the sudden signs of grace. I just was digging it lyrically and musically.
Thanks. You know, it's two verses. It's really, really simple. And I've always been an electric guitar player, you know, like grime and gristle rock and roll, and started playing a lot of acoustic before we started recording that album. The album's called Sudden Signs of Grace. And it's got a lot more acoustic on it. And the one that we did after that, which came out this year, which is called Sentimental Junk, is back to the electric thing. But this has got more acoustic stuff on it. And it was a cool little break there.
Yeah. Yeah.
I think sometimes the simple songs are the best ones where it's just that verse and chorus. I've been stuck on the song I Wonder from Rodriguez lately. And it's basically like he just says, I wonder, and then lists stuff he wonders about. And it's brilliant. It's like
one guitar. That's it. Yeah.
That's it. I can listen to that song over. Yep. So sometimes you hit on it right. And really, it's a great song.
The thing I really like about that song is the bass player, Kenny Aronson, who is a wonderful bass player, incredible musician. He's played with literally everybody in the world. Went fretless on that and just kind of had that nice burpy type of fretless tune on it. And then the video itself was produced by John Butcher, who's another great New England musician. It was kind of right in the middle of COVID, and nobody was really getting out to play. So we did this as sort of the alternative and had a bunch of our friends jump in and do little cameos in there too.
Yeah, really good stuff. Mark Sherry back with us.
Yeah, I just wanted to say great party tune. It's a great party tune.
For sure. So I think what we're going to do is jump into our next song, which is from the Meadows Brothers. And all these songs, please, everyone, you know, go find them, download them, buy them. That would be the best bet for us or for the artists. But we're going to bring up Ian Meadows from the Meadows Brothers. Before I get, it is Dustin Meadows' birthday today, and he is the other Meadows brother. The question you guys get all the time is, are you actually brothers? They are actually brothers. So Dustin's the baby brother, and it's his birthday. So happy birthday. We're going to play the song Trouble from Ian Meadows, or from the Meadows Brothers.
I've been lying out awake most every night, and I'm running out of ways to feel alright. Well, my wallet's almost empty, and the answers are all wrong. I'm troubled now, but I won't be troubled long. Well, my baby left me all alone and blue. What the hell's a worried man to do? She did cause me to weep, and she did cause me to moan. I'm troubled now, but I won't be troubled long. They say I could spot trouble from a mile away, but I let that same old trouble in with me today. Nothing is forever, and it'll soon be gone. I'm troubled now, but I won't be troubled long. Well, this old guitar has busted a few strings, and I don't have much money for these things. So I'll empty out my pockets till that change is all gone. I'm troubled now, but I won't be troubled long. Well, a worried man's got a worried state of mind, but he can't let it take up all his time. So he'll pick up that old guitar and write it in a song. I'm troubled now, but I won't be troubled long. They say I could spot trouble from a mile away, but I let that same old trouble in with me today. Nothing is forever and it'll soon be gone. I'm troubled now, but I won't be troubled long. I'm troubled now, but I won't be troubled long.
Good stuff. The yeah, it was interesting for me to see how much the studio has changed. So that was recorded here, that version. We are recording a new version for your guys' new record, The Meadows Brothers, Play It Right. Really great song. It's won a bunch of awards. Can you maybe tell us about awards? Could you tell us about that, Ian, maybe?
Oh, yeah. Sure. Most recently, we were down at Merlefest in North Carolina, which is a festival that Doc Watson started in memory of his son, Merle. And that was in the Chris Austin Songwriting Contest, which has been a longstanding songwriting contest down there. And it won first place in the country music category, which was really cool for me because one of my favorite songwriters, Gillian Welch, won the first Chris Austin Songwriting Contest like 27, 28 years ago, something like that. So it was just a really cool experience, and I wrote that song when I was maybe 20 years old. So it's kind of an old one in terms of my life, and so it's just nice to kind of, it still has some legs and people still dig it, which is the coolest thing.
Yeah, I think that's it, like, for everyone. I mean, when a song is good, it's good, and it just holds up, and it becomes timeless, and I think that's one of them. I know that was a song, honestly, Bell of the Fall covered that song because it's a great song. Dustin's harmonies on it are really great. I think a lot of times with you guys, I think there is that cool thing is that you start with this really great song and then it becomes better by the harmonies and everything else and what you guys bring to it as that brother sibling harmony thing.
Yeah, that magical sibling harmony, you know.
Yeah, there's nothing like it.
Yeah. And that was a live take. You know, that was guys sitting in a room playing and the new album.
Yeah, it's funny. I haven't seen that video for a long time. So it just kind of brings me back to recording that little session with you.
Yeah. No, fun stuff. The beard is longer now, too.
Yeah. Beard, about 6 years longer, probably.
Great guitar playing.
Oh, thanks. Sure. Thank you.
Really, really great song. That was actually, I'll mention that was recorded as a promo for Podunk, mm-hmm. who Mike Wilcox did an acoustic stage. Mike has since passed. They do a concert for him at the Old Church Concert Series. And Mike, the studio used to work with Mike to put on that stage, and he would bring bands in. And wonderful guy, great for the Connecticut portion of Western New England. For that part of the scene. So, I mean, great song. I mean, Narissa, I don't know if you had anything you wanted to add to the, as we're closing up this part of it.
I loved it. Like, it felt like something, I sing with my sister. Our band is composed of, my sister's the lead singer and I'm the harmony singer. So I'm, she's the you and I'm mm-hmm. the.
Sure.
Yeah. Dustin, is that his name? Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm the Dustin. Except I'm older. And I loved it. I wanted to cover it. It's just a beautiful, beautiful song.
Yeah. Oh, that's really nice. That's really, and I didn't get to say anything about your tune before, but I just did want to say what an honor to be here with you. I feel like in terms of legendary New England musicians, the Neilds, it's kind of a fixture here in the Northeast. So just really cool to listen to that song and to be here with you tonight. And Tom, loved your tune too, and not too familiar with your music and really enjoyed it.
Thank you very much. Check it out too.
Yeah, really good stuff. I should mention too that the newest version of that Dave Spinoza is playing on, and Dave Spinoza is an amazing session player from this area, from Western New England at this point. So and he's played on, you know, the first Paul Simon records and produced Ram for Paul McCartney. So that's kind of an exciting bit on that song as well. So I think what we're going to do now is we're going to play a couple songs for a couple people that aren't here. One is from Fountains of Wayne, who are from Williamsburg, Mass, the song Valley Winter Song, and then one of Ray LaMontagne's songs, who is from Asheville, Mass, Such a Simple Thing. And then we'll come back, kind of close up this segment.
Sounds good.
So bad, you know the summer's coming soon. Though the interstate is choking under salt and dirty sand, and it seems the sun is hiding from the moon. Your daddy told you when you were a girl the kind of things that come to those who wait. So give it a rest, girl. Take a deep breath, girl, and meet me at the Bay State tonight. The snow is coming down on our New England town, and it's been falling all day long. What else is new? What could I do? I wrote a valley winter song to play for you.
Yeah, really great stuff. Definitely, you know, great representations of the talent we have in this area. So at this point, I'd like to thank our first three guests, Tom, Gara, Narissa Neilds, and Ian Meadows. Thanks so much for joining us. It's an honor to have you here and hear your songs. You know, really great songwriters.
Thanks
so much, Tracy.
Yeah.
Really so great to be with you guys.
It's great to be with you guys too. It's an honor for me. You guys are both so incredibly talented and
right back
continued,
at you.
Continued success with your music.
You too. Thanks, Mark. Thanks, Tracy.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you, Mark.
Great stuff. So we're going to turn it over to, at this point, to Mark Sherry, who is going to take over for a little bit. I'll be back in a minute and we'll introduce the next bunch of panelists.
Cool. Well, first, I wanted to obviously to thank all the panelists here we had today. It was just so great tunes. And then obviously you've seen the two songs we played from people who weren't here today, you know, Fountains of Wayne, you know, and Ray LaMontagne, just incredible artists who are all from this region. So, what I want to, you know, talk about now, I want to show you is some of the ways that you can actually see the Essential Western New England Songbook. But first, the songbook has 200 songs in it. And this year, we added 49 songs to the original 151 that we had inducted last year. So let's take a look at the songs that are inducted this year. And you can see right there, we've got songs by some of the people, you know, who are appearing tonight, Eddie Seville and Eric Lee, you'll be seeing later on. And then you see songs by Taj Mahal, there's Tom Gehrer and the Meadow Brothers, West End Blend, MGMT. We got some great, great people who have been included in the songbook this year. Now for next year, the entire songbook, which has all 200 songs, you can access that through the Google Doc, which you can find on our internet website. And on that website, you can access the entire 200 songs. And we're going to show you screen by screen all the songs that are in there. So here you can see songs by local groups like Among the Acres, Bella's Bartok, old songs like In the Still of the Night by Five Satins, Dinosaur Jr., The Coyote Sisters, Christine Ullman, John Sheldon, Jim Henry, Jamie Kent, Mama's Marmalade, Jose Gonzalez and Banda Criolla, Old Flame, The Michael Cleary Band, Martin Sexton, Peter Newland, The Stone Coyotes, Shaka Zoba, Assize, Snowhouse, The Scud Mountain Boys, Roger Saloom, Teja New, Tom McClung, Tracy Grammer, The Whiskey Treaty Roadshow. So incredible people, 200 great songs. Now you can also listen to these songs as well on a Spotify and YouTube playlists. So let's take a look at what YouTube looks like. So when you access it on YouTube, you'll get a playlist like this, which you can see. These are some more songs that we have up there. There's the Arlo Guthrie, Alice's Restaurant, Bittersweet by John Sheldon, The Neighbors, Call Me Your Doctor, Play Like a Girl, June and Gene Millington. Some great, great tunes. And of course, Max Creek, I'm sure many people know. And now let's take a look at the Spotify playlist. And here we have most of the songs. They're not all on Spotify, but about 175 of them are. Refugees Are Welcome Here, Abe Loomis, The Drunk Stuntman, Downtown, Weeds and Wildflowers by Parson Fields. So some incredible tunes. And So where can you find all these songs? Well, you can find them all on our website, newmusicalliance.org. And you'll find links there to all three of those platforms. And I just want to mention one quick thing is that you'll also be able to hear those songs on and other songs by all of these artists and many, many, many great new artists on our weekly radio show, the New Music Alliance Radio Hour, which is broadcast and streamed on 8 different stations and also has all the shows archived up on our YouTube channel. So let's introduce the panelists for our next section, Group 2. And so Group 2, first we have Jim Armenti of the Lonesome Brothers. Jim, you out there?
Jim has left the building. He's
Jim
gone.
Jim has left the building.
Yes.
Okay, I think Jim's internet connection was not performing well, but we will still be playing their song. We also have Kyle Thomas. Who also goes as the musically goes as the name King Tough from Brattleboro, Vermont, and we'll be playing his song that's been inducted into the songbook called Sun Medallion.
Hi there.
How's it going?
Oh, good. That's great. And
good. And we also have Eddie Seville out of Waterbury, Connecticut. Hey, Eddie.
Hello. Great to be here.
We'll be playing your song, Carol Ann. So, Tracy, let's take it away.
Good stuff. So, yeah, we're going to start with Kyle Thomas. Of the band King Tough. Is this a band? Is it a band, or is that kind of your moniker?
Oh, it's just me.
Just you. Okay, so we're going to start with King Tough out of Brattleboro, Vermont, with a song called Sun Medallion.
Time out.
Good stuff.
That's great.
Yeah. Can you tell us a little about that? We found Jim Armenti. He's back. We've found him. So welcome to the show.
Wonderful. Oh yeah. You know, I wrote that song in about 2005. I was working at a thrift store called Experience Goods here in Brattleboro, and I got this little sun medallion, little necklace. I wore it on my, you know, I just had this necklace that I wore all the time, and the song just popped into my head one day, kind of out of nowhere, and I came home to my parents' house and recorded the whole thing in about an hour. I just played all the instruments. I just recorded it all in an hour, and it was done. And I can't tell you really, it's been incredible to just kind of see where the song has taken me. I kind of credit that song as taking me on my whole kind of career path. It's been kind of an incredible journey, just I think, and it has a lot to do with that song.
Yeah, I think that's, you know, we're talking about with the last set of panelists, and sometimes that's it. It's just, it's a really simple idea that comes. We find it, don't get in the way and just kind of let the song be what it is. And it sounds like that's what happened with this song for sure.
Definitely. Yeah. It just came right out. Easy as pie, you know.
Yeah.
didn't think about it.
Some you have to wrestle. Others just kind of flow out, you know.
Yeah. I think as I get older, I got to do a little bit more wrestling. But
sure.
That's pretty common.
Yeah, really good stuff. So hang out. We're going to listen to a few more tunes and, you know, get your input on those as well. Up next, we're going to play a song from Eddie Seville, who's out of Waterbury, Connecticut. It's a song called Carol Ann.
Deep in my heart.
That was Eddie Seville with Carol Ann. Was that officially the Steel Rodeo, or was that just
the was a Steel Rodeo? That was probably the last hurrah of that band. And if I could just say, the song is so simple, but the band really was great on that. We, at that point, we probably played over 100 shows, and we went into the studio and we did the record. The whole record was completely live. There was no overdubs, and it probably took 6 hours to do it. And it, that song just has some longevity. Like what I do now is almost completely different side of the coin. But yeah, that was the Steel Rodeo, and that was Billy Kay playing the guitar, and he's been with me forever. He kind of finishes my sentences.
I remember that band. I met you when you were in that band going back.
Yeah, that's right.
Probably 1990. It was a really great band. Probably one of my favorite bands in Connecticut.
Oh, well, thank you. Thank you.
Your sister, me too. Sally Lou. What's that?
I said one of my favorite bands too.
Yeah, there you go. The your sister Sally Lou was always like a big part of it for me. Your guys' her harmonies on your stuff.
She was the best. Her royal dryness.
Yeah.
She has the stage presence of a mortician.
Yeah, yeah. But she could sing, man. I loved her in that band. Loved that band for sure. And it's a simple song, but it's so simple. But it's one of my favorites from you for sure. And I think it's kind of cool that looking at your career, you've been playing Americana since I met you, you know, and it's like everyone kind of now is like an Americana artist.
Well, it wasn't hip, and I was considered like a hillbilly, but now I guess it's cool.
You waited long enough, and it's like my sideburns. You know, if I wait long enough,
they're always cool.
Fashion every 10 years, you know. So,
and can I just say before I know that we're running low on time, it's such a privilege to be counted among everyone here because they're great writers. And Tracy, thank you so much for nominating that song. It's really appreciated, man.
Yeah, man. No, like I said, you know, I'm a big fan, and I you know, you're one of Connecticut's. You know, I think I think you might be. You know, you're certainly considered one of the best bands in Connecticut for sure.
Well,
one of the best
songwriters.
So, yeah. Really good stuff. Are we getting Jim? Do you have a microphone?
I have a lot.
Okay, cool. I thought you were gonna have to like write it out on cue cards. No.
Look at here. See?
There we go. Beautiful. All right. That's it. Yeah, nice. So
we can hear you.
Jim Armenti is up next with the Lonesome Brothers. They're out of Northampton, Mass. I think that's our second band from Northampton, Mass. A song called Down by the Water.
Listening to our heart.
The Lonesome Brothers with Down by the Water, and we have Jim Armenti here. I'm assuming you're the principal songwriter on that, or was it a co-write, or... Are you there, Jim? Are you hearing me?
Uh-oh.
So there it is. Jim, if you want to just write it on cue cards and stuff. Or maybe. So Jim is frozen. Jim, I'm going to assume you were going to say some amazing stuff about that song. It's a great song. And listen, as all songwriters, it speaks for itself, right? I mean... you know, it's a great song. If we have to talk about it too much, it means we didn't do our job and write it well. So,
well, Jim,
good stuff. Eddie, what do you got any thoughts on that song?
I love that, man. That's so it's so down home, and it's so right on. Yeah, it's great. I love the pedal steel. Is that you playing pedal steel? One hand for yes, two for no.
kick your leg.
You know why I love it? I love it because it sounds like a band. It's so good.
For sure. Really good stuff. I think what we're going to do is play a couple more tunes and come back. Maybe Jim will have a microphone. If not, what we're going to do is we're going to have everyone just go to your next show, the next Lonesome Brothers show. And then you can tell us about the song there. We'll all have a big party at the next Lonesome Brothers show, wherever it is.
So let's not forget. Let's not forget Jim's songwriting partner in Lonesome Brothers, Ray Mason. So Ray deserves a shout out too, even though that's a song written by Jim Armenti, but Ray's written many of the Lonesome Brothers songs as well, which are incredible.
Good stuff. So we're going to hear two more songs from Western New England artists. One, both of these should be household names. If you don't know them, it's your fault that your record collection isn't up to snuff. So the first one is Taj Mahal, who's from Springfield, Mass, with the song Karina. And the second one is Big Al Anderson, who's from Windsor, Connecticut, and his song It Came from the South.
What a whistle, baby got it bird, honey got it bird, but sing. Baby got it bird, honey got it bird, but sing.
Black or white, blues or hillbilly,
It's got a rockin' rhythm knocking me silly, and every time I hear it, I'm as good as gone. Up or down, fast or real slow, that's all you hear on my radio. I never get tired, I can listen to it all night long. Well, it scared a lot of people when it first hit town. They didn't understand that they were putting it down, but it's lasted up until today, and we're still rocking around. And when they look back, trying to figure it out, where it came from and what it's all about, it didn't come from outer space, it came from the south. From real hard work, sweat from the brow, from poor people just pushing the plow, they meet up a river, trying to pass the time. It came from the truth, it came from the heart, it came from an old flat top guitar on a Saturday night, underneath the old moonshine. Well, it scared a lot of people when it first hit town. They didn't understand that they were putting it down. Lasted up until today, and we're still rocking.
Yeah, two amazing artists from the area, Taj Mahal, playing with the Rolling Stones there, Al Anderson, who went on to fame with NRBQ, but certainly his, I'd put any song on his first record, on that list. He's a really great songwriter, great guitar player. I'd really like to thank our guests from that, Kyle Thomas. Good to meet you. We've never met, but hopefully we'll hang out soon. And Deville, really always a pleasure to talk with you.
Thank you so much.
There you go.
Is he still here? Yeah. No, great. Again, a privilege to be counted among you. I sure appreciate it.
Sounds good. And I think the plan is this panel's coming back at the end, Mark?
At the very end, yeah.
Okay,
sounds good. Yeah, I just want to...
Yeah, if you guys want to hang out, then you're more than welcome.
And yeah, we're going to turn it over. For a little while, I'm going to be signing off the screen here and turning things over to our assistant director of the New Music Alliance, Mark Ramone. Yeah, anyway, take it away.
We're not hearing Mark right now. I don't know if that's just me. Looks like your mic is not on, Mark. So I'll start introducing the panelists as Mark figures this out. Maybe that's the best thing. In this next group, we have Eric Lee from East Hampton, Mass. We have Pony Bird from New Haven, Connecticut. We have Steve Rogers from New Haven, Connecticut. Big New Haven, Connecticut contingent in this one. And I don't know, is Jen here from Pony Bird? I didn't get the memo if she's not here. No Pony Bird. So she is not here. So we do have Eric Lee and Steve Rogers with us for this segment. Mark, did you figure out that microphone? Doesn't look like Mark figured that out. So it's funny at this point, Mark was supposed to, talk to me about the next song coming up. So maybe what we'll do is, I think he was just gonna introduce it first. So this next song is a song from the group called Bell of the Fall, which I was a member of. It was a duo with myself and Julia Autumn Ford. And I think Mark Sherry's gonna come back in to save the day. Here's Mark. Hey Mark, how's it going?
Hey, Tracy. Yeah. Well, technical difficulties, they'll always happen, right?
Yep.
So, yeah. Well, your group, Bell of the Fall, has always been one of my favorites, and I'm looking forward to hearing or seeing the video of your song Rise Up, which was inducted into the songbook this year. So let's take it away. Rise Up.
Change like how we love and what we make of moments as they pass us by. So rise up, face the day with convictions from deep inside. This time we won't be denied. When all is lost and hopeless has to find a cause, you still try to find the light and rise up, face the day with convictions from deep inside. This time we won't be denied.
Hey, Tracy, this song was amazing. I feel like you really wrote this song from the heart. And I'm just wondering how you came up with the idea for it.
You know, I've always been, it was kind of, I was writing for that group at the time. And we were basically doing mostly two-part harmony stuff. So I was trying to write something that was full two-part harmony, and then also trying to be in the vein of, I was always a fan of like the Sly and the Family Stone vibe of like songs like Stand and Everybody's a Star, and trying to write that kind of positive epic where it feels like, as a songwriter, sometimes it's easier to focus on you know, the negative side of things. That was really the goal, and to kind of write just a positive epic, and that's where we ended up.
Yeah, I just wanted to mention your duo mate, Julia Autumn Ford, who just has an absolutely gorgeous voice.
Yeah, Julia was going to be here tonight, actually, and it's snowing here. I don't know where, what it, how it is for everyone else, but it's snowing in Litchfield, Connecticut. We're up getting to, towards the hills of Litchfield, and she couldn't make it. So she still works at the studio with me. She's still, you know, we're working on, she's actually recording her a new solo album. I've released the solo album about a year ago, and I'm producing her new solo album. I'm working on a new solo album that she's producing for me. So we're still kind of doing stuff as that team, just not under the moniker Bell of the Fall right now. So
Mark Ramone, can we hear you yet?
Can you hear me now?
Yeah! Hey! Welcome to the party.
Oh, thank you. This is great. I'm Mark Ramone, in case you haven't heard. Assistant Director for the New Music Alliance and one of the hosts of the New Music Alliance Radio Hour. I've been broadcasting for many years and love to play local artists. I think we're fortunate to be in this area. Western New England is a musical hub, rich in diversity, a great place to live for those who want to be entertained by live music. From New Haven and Hartford, Connecticut, through Springfield, Holyoke, and Northampton, Mass., right on up into Brattleboro, Vermont. They're venues large and small for us to enjoy some of the best music in the country. Now I'm excited. I want to introduce the panel as I would have done before if the mic was working. Let's start with Eric Lee of East Hampton, Massachusetts. He was inducted for his song Heartache Town. Hello, Eric.
Oh, now you're.
There we go.
Eric doesn't have a mic.
It's contagious.
Yes.
We also have singer-songwriter Stephen Peter Rogers, representing the former band Mighty Purple from New Haven, Connecticut, in their song Everybody's Looking for Something. Hello, Stephen.
Looks like we're not hearing Steve either, so.
It's becoming a pandemic. And of course, I want to introduce our very own MC, Tracy Walton from Torrington, Connecticut, representing the duo Bell of the Fall that you just saw for their song Rise Up.
Yeah, it's good to be here. We were really honored to be nominated and to have the song go through and become part of the songbook. You know, and it's always nice. It feels like, and I haven't asked too many of the other artists, but it did feel like one of our better songs, you know, like we had favorites that we liked. It felt like, you know, one of those, which is nice that happened to go through. So
that resonates.
Yeah, you definitely one of those that did really well for us. That album did well on the folk charts. That song did really well. People actually thought it was a political song. Because of the title, and we started getting a lot of press on that, and we kept having to break it to everyone, like, it's not political. It's like we're saying, you know, rise up and just try to do better and try to be a better person and try to be more positive and all the things the lyrics talks about. And I think it was released in a time where it was like, you know, rise up against something, and it's wasn't really, that band was never about being against anything. It was more trying to spread love and positivity. So
yeah, that was released in 2018. It was the title track of your album Rise Up, and you shortly after went on tour with that album, hitting several cities in North America. How was the music received in other areas other than Western New England?
It was great. I think we did like 32 states with that album. We toured Canada with that album. We played South by Southwest with that album. So yeah, it was great. That band, it's funny. That's a band. It kind of like a lot of other things. You know, COVID kind of killed that band. we had just released our third album. The Bending of Light. God, I couldn't remember the name of it all of a sudden. You know, we just released it in at the end of November. We were planning a tour for the spring, everything. We were playing really good shows. Everything was good. And, you know, then the world stopped. And, you know, 2 years into it or whatever, it was just like, you know, being a dramatic band, we decided not to play anymore when no one could play anyways. So kind of, yeah, middle finger to it, I guess. I think, is Eric Lee, are you back, Eric? Can you talk?
Am I back?
You are. Eric's here. Wonderful.
Okay.
So I think what we'll do now is we're going to play Eric Lee. Eric Lee's from East Hampton, Mass., and his song is Heartache Town.
Well, hello, my friend. I see you there, that empty kind of looking stare. You're not feeling too good, are you? I can tell. Did you break your heart and find someone else? 'Cause I'm in that same boat myself, and getting through this world is hard as hell. But there's a spot not too far from here where the popcorn's free and the ice cold beer won't make you smile, but you'll forget how to frown. In a place called Heartache Town. Well, it's not all that much to describe, just a place where grooms that lost their brides and widows who gave up on try and go. And there are cops and chefs and hobos too. They're the same as me and you. They just don't want to live their lives alone. And a man named King who went insane lives by himself on Cherry Lane. And he says he lost his queen and his crown right here in a heartache town. Stay for too long, but there's room enough here for you if you've been done wrong. And if there's love left in this world, then there's just none to be found. Not here in a heartache.
Beautiful stuff. Really like that song. Yeah, really good. Feels like almost like it has a little bit of a Nashville vibe to me. Like I don't know if you've written in Nashville or are you like, have you done any like of that stuff?
I've never written professionally in Nashville. Well, in Nashville, but not professionally. So.
Okay, cool.
But you know about that.
Yeah, it has that vibe where like, you know, of sitting in a writer's room and coming up with that hook and everyone like high fives and like, yeah, that's it. We got one on the line. Don't lose it, you know?
Well, you know, something really funny about that is I wrote that song. We were just talking about great venues in Western Mass and, well, you know, and I went and saw Laurie McKenna at the Academy of Music in Northampton. And she's one of my favorite, you know, and obviously she's got a pretty strong, a Massachusetts connection, but also a connection. So maybe that was just on my brain. And I wrote Heartache Town the next day.
Nice.
Yeah, no, yeah,
really good.
I appreciate it.
Really good stuff. Steve, do we have you now? Or do we have you?
Do you?
Steve, we got you, man. How you been?
I'm doing good. Can you hear me?
I can hear you, man.
You can?
Yeah, good to see you. Good to hear you. Steve Rogers of...
Hi.
Who's going by the name Steven Peter Rogers for your solo stuff now, correct? Or...
Yeah, internet stupid thing that happened.
But we're here, yeah, you're here Steven, representing...
I go by... And I was in Mighty Purple for 20 years, 2000 and... so yeah, long time. Yeah.
And that's, it feels like, sometimes it feels like to me, like, you know, a band like that, maybe it's not happening anymore, but it's not, or it's, the band's not active, but it's not like the band's still playing without you. So really you're still a member of that kind of like, in you know what I mean? In a little way or whatever.
It was my week. Up singing together in church when we were, you know, but just sort of morphed into it as 12 and 13 year olds and songs together, and had a really, really nice one of those 20 years. You know, we did about 200, so we got really close in the, you know, we had not enough space, but we had a wonderful time. The song that these guys chose, you know, the songbook or whatever this year. Listening to this song in a long time, it feels like my prom photos and new girlfriend, or my, you know, my wife, my what's real, you know, I wrote this.
Well, let's hear the song. Steve Rogers, Mighty Purple from New Haven, Connecticut. The song is Everybody's Looking for Something.
Everybody is looking for something, for the places where they do belong. Now I know that I'm finally gonna get there, cause I know how to stand up on my own. So we finally crawl from the dark ages and we drive to the light. All the wars and all the superstitions, they will cling, 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 never let go. Everybody is looking for something, looking for the places where they do belong. Now I know that I'm finally gonna get there, cause I'm home. Yeah, I'm that we could measure on the scales, till the scales become all that we know. And can you measure up the light of Jesus with the stars and the galaxies and billions of suns, when all we have is a little scrap of paper and a wind, where is it from? Everybody is looking for something, looking for the place. Get there, cause
'cause I know how to stand up on my own. Everybody is looking for something, looking for the places where they do belong. Now I know that I'm finally gonna get there 'cause I'm home. Everybody is looking for something, looking for the places where they do belong.
Really good stuff. I think we're having a little trouble with Steve's mic, so we're going to talk a little bit about the talk. You're kind of cutting out. I think it's your Wi-Fi is what's happening. I don't know if you're on Wi-Fi or you're plugged in.
Yeah, I'm not.
Yeah, you're cutting in and out. So what we'll do is, just talk a little bit about the song. I think it's a great song. It's funny, as songwriters, it feels like we all feel like that, where even Ian Meadows, had a song, Troubled, from the Meadows Brothers, that was on her Trouble, which he wrote when he was 20. We all feel like we kind of take this arc that way as songwriters, and I think we do in ways, but there's also something that's can really strike home and hit home with songs we wrote as, younger guys, and I think that's certainly one of them that resonates. So, really good stuff. So, what we're gonna do, I think, is play. There's songs we have left from the band Low Lily from Brattleboro, Vermont. A song called "Hope Lingers On," and a song Dinosaur Junior. Called Feel the Pain. And we'll come.
My mother, when love is gone, my mother, when love is gone, in our darkest hour, hope lingers on. My father, when peace is gone, my father, when peace is gone, in our darkest hour, hope lingers on. I will not hate, and I will not fear, in our darkest hour, hope lingers here. My sister, when equality's gone, my sister, when equality's gone, in our darkest hour, hope lingers on. My brother, with tolerance gone, my brother, with tolerance gone, in our darkest hour, hope lingers on. I will not hate, and I will not fear, in our darkest hour, hope lingers here.
Junior, here we go.
Cool.
Really good stuff. I think we're going to bring some of the panelists back on. It's been an honor to host this and hear so many great songs, talk to so many great songwriters. It's really been a pleasure, and I hope everyone had a good time watching. I know I was texting with Julia Autumn Ford here. She's also listening to I Wonder, so we're a little obsessed with that song right now. So shout out to Rodriguez if he's still out there. And really good stuff. Steve, sorry about your microphone, but really good stuff. I hope to see you soon. And Eric, really good stuff. Dig the song. And are you working on anything new, Eric?
Yeah, I got a ton of new songs now. And right. I have another project that I put a bluegrass band called Poor Monroe.
All right.
And we do a lot of traditional bluegrass stuff. We do some of my songs too. So we got to get in the studio too. It's been fun. It's been nice to have a local bands.
All right, good stuff. Well, I know a really good studio. So if you need to come here, you're all set.
I might hit
back. Eddie, thanks, man. Always good to hang with you.
Thank you. Thanks to everyone. I appreciate being included.
Yeah, well, so I just want to thank everybody, obviously, for a great, great show. Tracy, especially for being our MC and doing a great job. I think it was just a really cool experience for everyone. It was just, anybody got anything they'd like to say to just wrap things up here before we do our ending? Any comments, Steve?
Mike's not working, so.
Anyway,
I just want something profound to wrap this up. Go ahead.
Yeah, I apologize to the audience for any technical difficulties they had to bear with. The internet is obviously flaky thing. So anyway,
all good.
I hope you enjoyed tonight's show. And if you like the idea of having the Western New England Songbook, which is something we all can be proud of, we'd really appreciate it if you could visit our website, newmusicalliance.org. And not only to get the website links to how you can listen to the songbook, which are all there, but also to open your heart and give a donation to help us to continue the work that we do to bring attention to and success to all the local musicians and communities of this beautiful area that we live in. Thank you. And anybody else have anything to chime in that regard?
I just want to thank you. I don't know about all, but I believe that I'm safe in saying we all tend to be relatively reclusive, which is why we start writing in the first place. This is an awesome chance to get to see real offering of so many different songs, just for myself, like this event, this concept. It's
right.
Really cool, and it means a lot to be included. And thank you.
I've personally just become a recluse. I was always very outgoing, but I've taken up reclusion.
Glad that you joined us.
Year, you know,
I was a recluse.
Well, I hope we gave a good idea of the breadth of the Essential Western New England Songbook. Out of those 200 songs that we currently have, we have so many different genres of music, and music all the way back to the 1950s up to just a year ago. And we'll be continuing to add to that every year through more nominations and a voting process that we do each year, and we hope you know, to have you join us. And Mark, would you like to sum everything up and take the show out for us?
Well, I'm just so impressed that we have such great music that's known across the nation, right from Western New England. It's great music. And thank you to all the panelists who are here tonight. Thank you to Tracy for emceeing the event. And I want to say, don't forget to check out our weekly radio show, the New Music Alliance Radio Hour, where you can hear great music from current and classic Western New England artists, including songs by the artist you saw tonight and other artists who have songs on the Essential Western New England Songbook. Now we're going to leave you with one more song from this year's Songbook inductees. Let the multi-million selling band All That Remains from the Chicopee and Springfield, Mass area take it out with What If I Were Nothing. But first, I want to hope to see you all soon and perhaps at the Valley Music Showcase to welcome on the spring, which will be held on Saturday, April 29th. We'll be live at the Glendale Ridge Vineyard in Southampton, Massachusetts. Information on Facebook and Instagram to come. So thank you all and good night.
Thank you. Good night.
Just let it go, don't wanna argue anymore. I can't be sure I know just what we're fighting for. I know you're scared and that you're thinking I may go. I'm not leaving, I'm not leaving. And if you're thinking I might, might be led astray, just remember this one question. We'll be right back.